down with TTT. He's a Navy boy, so you know he needs help, right? Keep holding it, baby. One more term. One more term, Bill.
That's funny.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Okay,
put this. Now you're going to tuck it inside there, baby. Big, huh? Gangway. Gangway, baby, gangway. That's what this is called. We'd like to present you as a small token. This is our coin from the American Legion Post. We're a memorial post named after Sergeant Thomas Oliver Ahlberg. His name's on the chip. I encourage you to research the mission in Vietnam.
Yes, sir. I will do that when I get off this watch.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it.
Awesome. So game plan today, we'll hit the main areas of the ship. Just broad overview. So we are a San Antonio class LPD. We are amphibious. So taking the Marines and their equipment to shore is our bread and butter. We are up here on the flight deck now. You can see some of our helos that we're currently embarked with. We are deployed right now with the Macon Island ARG. So Macon Island obviously pulled in right in front of us. I think you guys are going to be going on board there after this. And then the Anchorage, they're currently down at Sadaheep. They're down there. We just finished working. We're with the 13th MU is who we're deployed with. They just finished up Exercise Cobra Gold. So that's what brings us here to Thailand. But we're fully loaded out for our deployment. So you'll see as we walk around, it's kind of tight with all the Marines equipment. But that's why we're here. That's what we do, is to take them to shore so they can execute their mission. But yeah, so this is the flight deck. Like I said, 53s.
Before we get started, this is our guy in charge today.
Awesome.
Tell him who you are.
I'm Neil Willman.
Okay.
Retired commander, SWO. I've done at least 3 of the 4 jobs that you guys were talking about, so I'll tell you privately which one I hated the most. we're very happy to have you here and show us around.
So. I'm Bill Ahlberg. I'm the commander of the American Legion Post TH02 in Pattaya.
Sweet.
Thomas, second vice, American Legion, Pattaya.
This is my wife, Tuna Karn, Thai citizen extraordinaire.
Awesome. Awesome.
And this is my wife, Nam Yin, which translates to cool water.
My name's Earl Kershaw. I'm VFW in Banchan, Nodupau. And this is Sam. She's from Cambodia. You from where? Figueroa Tech?
University of Southern California.
Figueroa Tech. Yeah. I'm from UCLA.
UCLA guy? Yeah.
I thought I heard that.
Yeah.
Yes. I'm Steve Causal, retired Air Force. Out there, out at VFW Post 12146 down in Banchan, and happy to be here.
Yeah. Yeah, very much so. Thank you for your service, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Appreciate it.
Thank you,
sir.
Sweet. Thank you so much.
Token of the American Legion. American Legion Post.
Thank you so much.
We're Memorial Post. Thomas Oliver Alberg. His name's on the coin. I encourage you to look up his mission.
Thank you.
Vietnam era.
I will.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. Post coin.
Thank you,
Thomas
sir.
Oliver Alberg. Thank you. Thank you, guys. We appreciate it. Appreciate it very much. And yes, I still have one for you. Gunnery. Gunnery. Thank you. Watch your step.
First time in my life,
Nam Yen, first time.
First time in the ship.
First time inside the ship.
Airport, what's it?
Yeah.
Airport ship?
Navy.
Navy ship.
Navy, U.S. Navy. Yeah. Navy, and they take the Marines. They take the Marines to the land. Yeah, for fire. You have to be ready. A fire, very scary on a ship, huh? They have alarms everywhere. It's a lot of dang stairs. On the bridge. Wow, amazing.
It's a little hot.
It's a little hot.
Like my helicopter.
So welcome
in the afternoon.
You
go there.
I cannot go.
Yeah.
Know this is where we
That's the afternoon.
Well, we're American here is too. Joe Travis. He's our actual navigator on board. So I'll let him talk about.
Hi, Joe.
What we're doing up here.
Ernest Hemingway. Don't let him lie.
Take it away.
Okay. So, like I said, this is the pilot house. Is where we drive the ship normally. For myself and my team, we operate out of this area over here. This is where we actually, as we're pulling in and out of port, or we're just going through any waters, this is where we actually navigate from. I'll normally stand right here while the rest of my team is back here and taking bearings with the bridge wings to make sure we navigate safely in the port. Because we rely a lot off of GPS now, but we still practice everything, because these are all just electronic charts. So we actually take visual and radar positions. That way we can correlate where GPS is. That way, in case we ever lose GPS or any other electronic position source, we can still drive like old-fashioned way with instead of a paper chart, it's just more electronic now. So we're just drawing lines on the consoles here instead of actually just paper. We do have paper charts. They're all within the desk here, so we can still use those. We're not supposed to, but we have them just in case. But then other than that, we have our helm console and our lee helm console over here. So that's where our helmsman will sit and actually adjust the speed and drive the ship as we're going through. All the rest of these screens and everything you see here can be reconfigured to basically make sure we can see our speeds, pitch, how winds are affecting us. And then the other console behind you there is actually one of our radar displays. Those are the main screens that we utilize in here, but then we have the captain's chairs, the one on the right there and the one in the center, and we have the exos chair in the left corner there. We still do have a bunch of manual systems, so we have like mow boards and scales that we utilize just in case to back up, because you can't always trust electronics, so we like to make sure that we have that the older way of doing it learned. It's just like we also still practice celestial navigation on board here, just in case, because you never know what's going to happen. So we have all that equipment still in my chart room over there.
So like an old sextant?
Yep, we got all those on board still.
Wow.
We still practice utilizing that, and we still practice it today.
Nice.
So here's a question for you.
Absolutely.
You remember the incident in the Suez Canal? Where
yes.
That big tanker ran aground?
Yep.
Since you're being the navigator, in your opinion, because everything's opinion-based, what did they do wrong?
They were trusting too much in the electronic portion of the system instead of just looking outside.
Oh, really?
That is one of the major things that actually affects ships these days. Not necessarily all the ships that I've been on, but in terms of a lot of commercial ships, yeah. There'll only be one person on a bridge this size, and they're mainly going to be at the helm console or looking at an electronic version of a chart instead of just looking out the window. And that can, just looking at, especially in such a tight spot, looking out the window is going to give you the most to see how everything is passing through. And if you cut anything close, you'll get the best to just make sure you're correlating that information together.
So I'm an old helicopter guy, and our GPS was like Nat's ass, so we could land in a 10-foot square, you know, in the middle of the night. Is that kind of system incorporated into commercial ships like that?
So depending on the company, yes. Like that console behind you, that one that has the white cover over it,
yep.
that is actually commercial radar.
Okay.
So we do have that, and that is utilized on a lot of modern ships.
Uh-huh.
It is good. It is not my favorite,
right.
Just out of a practical sense, because it is off by a little bit sometimes, mm-hmm. depending on because it's all radar, so it depends how it picks up the cross section of a ship. So some smaller ones are more difficult to pick up, or and then larger ones might be deceiving in regard to actually how large they are. So they're not perfect, but they get the job done. But really, nothing beats just looking outside.
Yeah.
Taking a little bit of your tour for a moment here.
Absolutely.
Come over here. I want to tell these folks because they don't know. Anybody know what this is? Besides him, I mean.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Lisa,
I have it on my camera.
What is it?
Over here?
Go ahead, tell him. Somebody take over here now.
Uh-oh.
That's the ship's clinometer.
What this does, folks, right now this ship is very stable. Okay? So this shows you if the ship, how much the ship is rocking this way, how much the ship is rocking this way. And when you get below here, you're really in trouble.
You're swimming.
And the other portion of it is right up above you. That's for the pitch of the ship to see how far we're going forward and backward.
So even with all of the electronics that modern day ship has, some of the old visual stuff is still utilized and probably always will be. When I was in the Navy, we had oars and we didn't have one of those.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. The man who died, who gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, an American, where at least I know I'm free, and I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Thank you, Captain.
Such great folks that come to tour and support us, and it's good to know that we have such wonderful support behind us.
You bet. We appreciate it. You can tell all these guys when they're veterans and they're on the Eastern Seaboard.
Yes,
they got family right here, American Legion and VFW Post both. So
yes, sir.
Check that out, guys. Whoa.
What would you like to do?
What an honor.
So if they give you what?
If I open up, would we do have the Marines fully embarked, it's almost 1,000 people that have to push through every meal in about an hour and a half.
You don't have to bend down.
So the lines will get backed up, but they have an efficient system to get everyone through. And then once they have their food from one of the two lines,
mess hall.
I'll show y'all where the mess decks are.
This is where we come eat. Can feed 1,000 people this. Yeah, big kitchen. You smell? Yeah. Oh, they have a lot of food on here. Oh, dining room. Whoa.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Permission to come aboard. Sure. Thank you. Jack's place. Oh, loving it. Look at this dining hall. Wow.
Hey, we're supposed to be in the other one.
Raised up just because we're doing other little ceremonial stuff here on this side. But yeah, this is the main one. Behind you is a decontamination station. This is for the other side. I don't know if you saw in the shipping P-way. If there's a patient or any kind of CBR attack, so chemical, biological, radio, kind of that kind of stuff, they get seen over there. They get into the eye wash station or shower. They get transported in between the stations, and then we can grab the patient from that side and make sure that he's all good and we can get him and not be contaminated ourselves. This is where the decon station is. Here on this side, this door, that's just the hangar bay. I'm pretty sure y'all have seen that. That's just the other side. The main reason why...
We're going there
next. Yeah.
Yep, we'll go out there next.
When you go out there, you'll notice like there's a reason why medical is right in the middle. In case of any fire accidents in the hangar bay, they have immediate access to come back here. So it's a straight passageway. So yeah, this is our triage area. This is where most of our patient care is seen. As from the vital signs machine, everything else that we have on here. Here real quick, this is just our mobile x-ray, so we do have x-ray capabilities. I'll show you the room next with the actual fixed x-ray table. This is one of our mobile x-rays. This is a lot more thicker. That corner on that side is just the dental side. We also have dental capabilities. So we mainly see obviously our own people for the yearly exams and everything else. And then sick hall as well for them. They have the same rules. Coming in the morning, and having stuff, and treating everybody. You guys have any other questions, comments?
Well, thank you so much for the tour. Yeah. Had no idea you have an entire hospital for these.
Yeah, it's a miniature hospital on here.
Exactly.
Behind the Macon Island, because they are a LHD, are a little bit bigger than us, but we're right behind them as medical capabilities. We have over about 400 pieces of equipment on board. So all those pieces of equipment I have to maintain and make sure that they're up to code, and all of these machines aren't putting out any false codes as well.
There you go.
So that's what I do specifically here. But we have x-ray techs, lab techs, dental techs, and even an independent duty corpsman, which has a license as a provider to see patients.
Nice.
HM2 has been essential for us to have on board because we were gapped a little while where we didn't actually have a biomed tech. And so he came on board and was able to get things turned around. So he's been a huge asset for us.
Good job. All right. Thank you for your service. Hooah. Hooah.
Yes, let's go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You guys have a good one. Thank you.
Thank you.
Matter of fact, Thomas, I got...
What the hell?
I got one left.
What the hell are we underneath, Bill?
It's 53.
53?
We have one in the hangar.
Wow. We walked right through the door and I'm like, well, that's incredible. Do you paratroopers jump out of these kind of? Or no?
We don't have any paratroopers. Oh, watch
okay.
We don't have any paratroopers on board.
Right.
Think they do. I think that's more fun.
But feasibly, they could, I guess.
Feasibly, yeah, people could jump out.
All right. Nice. This is a Marine show.
Yeah.
Man.
The main purpose of this is to move people and stuff.
Okay.
That's what they do.
pretty heavy lifter, pretty good sized cargo. Yeah. Wow. Incredible. Isn't that nice, babe? I can't believe it fits in here the way it does. Like, we came through the door and we're right underneath the belly of it. It's incredible. It's definitely in the stored position, isn't it?
Yes. So the tail, that aft,
uh-huh,
is folded in.
Oh.
It's like folded right, you can kind of see it.
Yes.
Like the rest of it. So that will extend out. And
extends up.
And then all the blades are like in their folded position.
So which one's this hole designed for the chopper, or the chopper designed for the hole to where it just like barely fits? What do you?
I don't know which came first.
Time and place.
I will say that Thailand has been my favorite place to
come. Really?
We've been here for 3 months.
You don't want it to bind up on the recoil, so you keep it so it's not going to get rusty with the salt.
Put Vaseline on it.
You should know that. They taught you that in the chow hall back in the day.
With the WD. Spray to hell.
Well, they got a lot of vehicles.
Well, guys, we've had an amazing tour here aboard the Murtha. Thank you to all of the Navy crew, our wonderful tour guides, these two ladies over here, the captain, of course. We've had a fantastic time on behalf of the American Legion Post, TH02 in Pattaya, as well as the two VFW post, 12146 in Banchan and 9876 in Pattaya. On behalf of all three American Veterans Organizations, we want to say thank you. Thank you very much to the United States Navy. There's the Murtha, guys. That's the one we just took the tour of. And then this afternoon, there's another tour. This one was in the morning. American citizens and foreign nationals. You had to register to get booked in, of course, and go through security. But the next tour this afternoon is this one over here. And it's for American citizens only. So Namien and I won't be going on this one here. But you can tell they got a huge flight deck. They've got airplanes on board. So that's going to be an amazing tour. So unfortunately, I won't be able to get footage of the tour on that today. Namien and I have been up here since early this morning, so we're going to head on back home. And some of the guys are going to stick around. This is for American citizens only to tour this ship. But we sure had a great day on the J.P. Murtha, John P. Murtha. Thanks for watching.
So this area right here is for the Memphis and St. Louis people to fight about which one is better. Okay? And it's free!
All this food, courtesy of the veterans of the Eastern Seaboard. Can you handle that? All right, guys. Thank you for your service. Thank you for your service. Here we go. Good job.
We got a service.
Thank you for your service. Thank you for your service.
Thank you.
You bet. Oh, thank you guys. Thank you guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, Krispy Kremes.